Hey folks, this is BestInSlot and welcome back to our Jurassic World Evolution 2 Mod Spotlight series. Yes, less than a week after Update 6 and less than a week after the Feathered Species Pack, modders have added new species into the game, fantastic new cosmetics into the game, and all the other mods in the past did work as well. So my disclaimers this time weren't so necessary, but it is worth noting, as per usual, mods can possibly break your game. This is a good time to mod if you've been curious or you want to try it out, because for the next 3 months or so until the next update, we assume, you'll be pretty safe, you'll be pretty free to go, nothing's going to change. This is prime time post-update to start modding, but problems can occur. If problems do occur, it's not my fault, it's not the mod maker's fault, and most importantly, it's not Frontier's fault. But really nice to see that nothing was broken this time around. Asmodeus is not here because I don't want to do the voice, he's off getting hench, lifting lemons with his pinky. Anyways, so only 5 mods to check out today. Obviously, post-update, people take a little bit of time, but we do have 2 mods focused on creatures from the Feathered Species Pack, which I'm really excited about. So let's go check them out. First up today, we have a new Deinocheirus cosmetic. Worth noting, every single mod I'm going to show you today, and they've all kind of been spoiled down on the left, is a new cosmetic or variation. Nothing is lost by installing these mods. Here we go. Okay, here we have Deinocheirus merificus, which is the full genus and species name. This is made by Wheat with Skins from Game Videos for Life. Original art that this was based on by Gael Seguilo. and of course, it's based on the Deinocheirus from Prehistoric Planet. It is the Prehistoric Planet Deinocheirus come to life. It's got that shimmering black body, those white stripes down the back. Then that same drooping tail, and then most importantly for the Deinocheirus from we get to see the animation. Maybe my favorite social animation. Love that one. Yeah, it's got that sort of lovely swathe of blue here as well. A little bit of blue feather, a little bit of blue skin, and a little bit of blue sort of texture there around the eyes. Looks absolutely fantastic. And I would love a whole pack eventually of Prehistoric Planet inspired animals, so we could do a proper Prehistoric Planet park, especially with season 2 on the way within the next few months. Trailer this week, hopefully, if not next week. There's also been some model changes though. It's not just a new skin. There's been which is a thinner neck. It's got a thicker fingers. The face has been edited as well. It's got a little bit less of a camel problem that the one from Frontier does occasionally have. The Frontier one is absolutely beautiful though, and I love that we can now take those beautiful Frontier Deinocheiruses and other dinosaurs and throw in new skins that work really well as well. You know, these beautiful variations on our feathered dinosaurs. So as I say, you don't lose anything by downloading this. If you want to play with a Prehistoric Planet Deinocheirus, you can do that. Looks absolutely beautiful. As per usual, all these mods will be linked down below. Look at it. I mean, up close, it shimmers a little bit weirdly, but from a distance, it is a beauty. It really is. It kind of feels like watching Prehistoric Planet come to life that I can control. I have the power. Right, moving on very swiftly. We're going to nip over here next to our single aquatic creature. We have another Nothosaurus mod. I'm not going to talk too long about this one because we have done all the fun paleo facts for the Nothosaurus in the past, so I'm not going to do them again, but it is by HawkAl1215. It is a sauropterygian reptile. These were a group of aquatic reptiles that kind of evolved from their land-based predecessors, and they flourished during the aquatic. And of course, Nothosaurus appeared in Camp Cretaceous. We showcased a Camp Cretaceous inspired version fairly recently, but this is a much more realistic aquatic version of the same creature. And yeah, it makes a lot of sense. It would have been a predominantly aquatic creature, if not wholly aquatic creature, really. So the Cretaceous one is pretty wild. This is much more in line with what we'd expect. I really like this like pouch we've got going on here, the skin flap hanging down the middle. We've got those jutting perfect teeth to catch fish. You know, you see a lot of aquatic-based creatures have these teeth that jut out at bizarre angles. It's because it lets them spear fish a lot easier. Those dead snake-like eyes. Some lovely colours and a nice little paddle tail there at the back. And some lovely flippers as well. Hokal has done a fantastic job. It's also teeny tiny. Lovely skins as well. I really like this one in particular. That's really cool looking. Anyways, moving on. That is our lovely Nothosaurus. Next up we have one of the weirder mods. In there. I'm just going to show you this one. This is a Ceratosaurus variant. So, Claire, no. I guess it might be hard to tell instantly. This Ceratosaurus is tiny. I mean, look, Ceratosaurus is smaller than Deinocheirus, as is, but this one is absolutely minuscule. Jurassic World Evolution 2 has a bit of a scale thing where basically everything is scaled up and then some dinosaurs come in and they're not. The Yutyrannus, for example, is quite realistically sized, but lots of other dinosaurs are really humongous, so Yutyrannus feels small. This is also true now for Ceratosaurus. This is the realistic size of Ceratosaurus. This is the size it was in reality compared to like the humans and stuff like that. And it is about a third of the size of the one in Jurassic World Evolution 2, which of course is based on the Jurassic Park 3 one, which is also gigantic. This is made by Master Do. Apologies, I should have said that much earlier. And I do actually really like it. I really like this new skin. It feels like a completely different dinosaur because it doesn't have that telltale JP3 skin. Much smaller, more spikes. The jaw, of course, has been remodeled. Much more curvature in there. A lot skinnier as well, that lower jaw. The arms are a little bit stubbier, I think. And we've got this lovely curved keratin here. Feels a little Primal Carnage Extinction-esque in a little way as well. I'm not saying that's the inspiration, but it does feel a little bit like that as well. But I really like how it looks. I think the skin is beautiful. And it's a really cool little Ceratosaurus. And again, if you wanted, you could use this as a variant, have the default one in the game, and you've got a little bit of a life cycle thing going on there. They look demonstrably different in some ways, but you could say it's an alternate species, or you could say it's a juvenile, whatever you want to do. Or you could have a realistic park. The world is your oyster. Now, just before we move on, however, one of the images for this Ceratosaurus was a bit of a teaser for an upcoming mod by Master Do. And I'm going to bring that image up on screen right now because it's super hype. And I want everyone to get excited about it as well. Are you excited yet? As you can see in the background, it looks like a V-Rex, a Vestastosaurus Rex from King Kong, my beloved King Kong 05, Peter Jackson's King Kong. Or Peter Jackson's King Kong, the official video game of the movie. One of my favourite games. Anyways, very excited about a potential V-Rex mod. We haven't had any daft mods for quite a while. Or even just sort of slightly further out of the canon mods like that. So that'd be really cool. Very excited about that. What's that? I was meant to show you something else as well. Another picture. I can't remember what it was. I've probably already shown you it. Anyways, moving on to our penultimate mod. This is a Yutyrannus variant. Yutyrannus' animations have grown on me a lot since it first came out. That bird-like quality to them is pretty bloody cool. Now, some of you avid dino collectors out there will recognize this Yutyrannus instantly. This is the PNSO Yutyrannus. Now, PNSO, oh, by Game Videos for Life and Viral Cyclops. PNSO make a bunch of really cool dinosaur toy model kind of things, if you're into that sort of thing. Quite realistic and popular dinosaur models, and they do have a really nice focus on realism. For now, this is just a skin. Oh, that's the image I'm going to bring up. I'm going to show you the comparison. I'm going to show you the PNSO Yutyrannus at the side. Hopefully, let's get a good shot there. Hopefully, you can see that on screen now. So you can see how the skin has been translated into the Evolution 2 Yutyrannus. It gives it a completely different feel, I've got to say. This is unlike anything else we have in the game. I probably do prefer the default Evolution 2 version, but this is still pretty sweet. And the PNSO one is much beloved by many people, so I'm sure some people would love to have this wandering around their park. Expertly done by GVFL, as per usual. Or James Videos for Life, as I call him. But, yeah, beauty. Really, really well done. Love to see things like that come to life. And speaking of toys and dinosaur models coming to life, we have a couple of T-Rex variants to finish off. So this is a mod by Game Videos for Life and Viral Cyclops. Again, I hate that E, by the way. Cyclops. Every single time I want to say Cyclops. And Norfire. So this Norfire did the original Rex remodel. And then GVFL, I think, made the skins, and Viracyclops helped get them in-game, basically. And they've come up with several cosmetics based on Jurassic Park Trespasser, on the Kenner and Hasbro lines, you know, the Jurassic Park toys, the Kenner stuff from the 90s, and also Nanmu, which is a company I hadn't heard of, although I'd seen their images. And Nanmu, again, do fantastic dinosaur maquettes, statues, models, that kind of thing. They're kind of like a cheaper alternative to Sideshow's Dinosauria, I would suggest. And I can't remember which one is which, so let's just release it. I think this is the Kenner bull. We'll find out in a second. I've got to be honest. I was never like a big... Oh, what a beauty. That is the toy, isn't it? Yeah. The Kenner bull Tyrannosaurus. What an absolute stunner she is as well. I guess he. It's a Kenner bull after all. Yeah, looks really, really cool. Love that coloration. That blue and orange really pops together. I mean, it's a classic. It's the Battlefield combination right there. It looks really cool. Norfire's Rex remodel already has such fantastic detail and texture as well. And that's just been amped up with the addition of all those lovely colours. What an absolute stunner he is. Well, look, you're very pretty. Do you know that? Do you know how pretty you are? Do you know? Do you? Oh, hello. I'm basically inside you. Yeah, so that is the bull one. I'm only going to show you two of them. Definitely go check out the mod for yourself to see. See what I mean? It's quite the gap now, whereas usually Ceratosaurus is up here somewhere. Yeah, that is a beaut. It really is. I've never really collected dinosaur toys or anything like that, even though there's some beautiful ones out there. So a lot of this goes over my head, but I can definitely appreciate a beautiful paint job like that. And this one is the Trespasser Tyrannosaurus, one I can appreciate as a humongous fan of Jurassic Park Trespasser. Oh, dramatic. I mean, come on. That's awesome. Very, very cool. I mean, typically cool. Again, My Chemical Tyrannosaurus Rex. I really need a better emo joke. I'm going to come up with a different band every single time. So this is Bullet for My Tyrannosaurus Rex. Again, I mean, the skin has been translated so well. It looks so much better than it ever did on Trespasser for fairly obvious reasons. But that black and red, yes, it's a cliche how to make something look cool color combination. But you know what? There's subtle yellow in there and there's orange and it's kind of like a flame. It's like a burning out flame or a flame rising up from its sort of its stomach and its core. Let's say, I was going to say cervix for some reason, rising up from its core. And then you know, the smoke and the ashes blacking out the sky behind it. Again, yeah, it's cliche cool stuff, but for a reason, because it looks awesome. It's a quintessentially cool color combination, and he or she or it, whatever it wants to identify as, is an absolute beauty. Yeah, what a stunner. What a stunner. So, where have you gone? You're doing this on purpose, aren't you, Rex? I know you. There we go. So we're going to end it there. Thank you so much for joining me, my lovely ladies, and I can't remember what it is. Thank you so much for joining me. Yeah, mod spotlights are back. People are still releasing fantastic stuff. Everything is working. My mod collection, I'm keeping fairly chill. We're going to start a park at some point, hopefully this week or next week. I don't know what we're going to do quite yet. We'll talk about that in the future. But eventually, when the game does stop updating, I'll do my big master mod list with all the very best mods you should download. I'll do the recommendations and all that kind of jazz. But we're going to save that to the end, and hopefully Evolution 2 has lots more life in it, because as much as we love the modding scene, as much as I personally love the modding scene in this game, and I love the creative control more than anything else, and all these incredible looking variants, that really is Prehistoric Planet come to life. You know, it's always a credit to Frontier that the updates and the DLC are so fantastic that they inspire all this modding work in the first place. And I think it's important to make sure we're crediting Frontier as well as all the talented modders, because they riff off each other in a lot of ways. That's how it feels. Right, anyways, thanks for joining me. Throw me a like down below if you enjoyed the video. Stick around this week for more dinosaurs. Probably. I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.